Yo, CPA Strength here, back with his 100th Accounting for Beginners video. That's the confetti. Yo, thanks for being here. Thanks for everybody supporting. We're gonna have more fun in this one. Might do a possible another video about my 100 videos of Accounting for Beginners. I just wanna say, you know, when I made my first Accounting for Beginning video, I might have had like 5 or 10 subscribers. I mean, I started with one just like everybody else. Now I'm up to about 67,000 subscribers. But anyways, check this playlist out. That's where I have 99 other videos, another Accounting for Beginners videos. Please like the video. That's how you can support me. That's really all I ask. Comment, that helps the channel grow too. Like and comment. You could share on social medias if this helps you. Also, check out my live streams. I'd be doing live streams. I'm doing a 30-day push-up challenge. Had some people actually do push-ups with me today in a live stream, so I do that at noon Eastern. Anyways, let's get into it. Lego 100. Y'all, can we believe it? We're going to the basics. There's a lot of new people taking accounting for the first time. And maybe if you've been taking accounting for a while, and you know what, we're just gonna pick this bone right now, and we're gonna pick this bone. I'm gonna shake a stick at this. Everyone's like, you could have done the whole video in 1 minute. Okay. That's like an accounting textbook. The reason you're here is because your accounting textbook is so dry and you're not getting any value from it, because it's just A plus B equals C. Bah, bah, bah. 1 plus 2 equals 3. Bah, bah, bah. And there's nothing, no context, no humor, no nothing about it. So I understand I elaborate and I make something small. You know, I could do this whole video in a minute. It might be 5 or 6, 7 minutes. I don't know. Now, conversely, you know, you go really fast. You go really, really fast in your textbook. It's like, just give me the answer. It's like, okay, I got the answer. Boom. And then guess what? You don't really know it. You might have been, oh, well, this said that. You don't really know it. So you got to relearn it. So you're going fast all the time and not really learning anything. Okay, maybe if you just relax, take 6, 7 minutes, and this is like for all of my Accounting for Beginners videos, pretty much. I do some fast ones, like 5 minute ones. But yeah, I mean, I hope you can just relax a little bit. Yeah, it's gonna take 4, 5, 6, 7 minutes. It's gonna take a lot of extra time. You know, what's 5, 6 minutes? I mean, come on. And then maybe I'll tell a story, or the way I say something, it'll stick in your head, and then you don't have to remember this again. You don't have to relearn it. You don't have to watch the video again. So that's my little rant, and anyways, let's get into this, all right? This one is number 100, of course. I already mentioned the, boy, let's get a bicep shot in there, boy, what? Anyways, liabilities equal 18,000. Equity equals 32,000. What are the assets? Hold on a second. Is that gonna be any better? I don't know, I still don't have the lighting down. I don't like it when I'm over here, really. Yeah! One take, Timothy. Oh, that's way better, bro. Damn, I should have done that way before. Oh, well, we're always making improvements, right? So anyways, liabilities, 18K. Equity, 32K. Assets, I'm sorry, I don't like to abbreviate. 18,000 liabilities. Equity, 32,000. What are the assets? And you're like, you might see, your first quizzes are coming up, your first tests are coming up. You're like, I have no idea about it. But you have been writing DC Adler on your paper every day from Accounting for Beginners 99. So you have been doing this, debit, credit, asset, and I put withdraw, that's my new thing. I wish I would have started with that. And then expenses, so And then liability, equity, owner's equity, and revenue. So you've been DC-A-D-L-R. So you already have this. Now this is mainly for journal entries, but I'm gonna show you just for like a question about this, DC-A-D-L-R also does apply. And it's also like a T account too, but anyways, this does apply. I'll show you, look, and look, it has liabilities, and that's right here. Equities in the question, and that's right here. And assets, it wants to know how much assets, and assets is right here. So you have those three here. You have been knowing assets equal debits equals credits always. So you're probably gonna have an equal sign here, okay? Now I know we're not doing that, but you're like, and you're just gonna, and it'll make, I put, this is my little house right here, or this is my a building warehouse. This is a bit office building warehouse type thing that a business owns. That's the asset. I just don't want to say like what assets, right? Let's go over here. So anyways, you have a house, and that's an asset. I think you have an office building, and that's your asset, right? Now, I think this'll, the door moved and the window moved, it transposed it. But now, that is your asset, a office building, a house. You've been writing down different kind of assets, so you can try to think of an asset. Okay, now, because it wants to know, what are the assets out of this equation? You're like, I don't know, bro. Well, just chill. Think about it, you have an office building. What is normal on an asset like an office building? You buy a mortgage. Sometimes you don't have a mortgage if you would pay for cash for the whole business or for the whole building right when you started. So you either you have a house, you either owe somebody, you either owe a bank money or you own it yourself, right? So an asset, you either owe somebody, right? Or the building, the owners of the corporation own the building. So either you owe somebody, You have a building, either you owe somebody, a third party, or the owners own it. Okay, and now can we all say the office building is an asset, right? Like what's an asset? Oh man, he's an asset to the team. He goes fast, he goes hard. You know, is a building an asset? Yeah, it's an asset. It's gonna help you. It's gonna help you make money over the long term. You know, you're gonna store stuff in there. You're gonna go there to work. You're gonna transport stuff. So we can all agree on a building is an asset. What is it when you owe somebody in accounting terms? You know, it'd be a liability. Think about it. A liability is, if you can think about it like sports terms, like he is a liability. He can't catch the ball. You know, he's slow. He's a liability for the team. Now, would you think, now in accounting terms and business and money, you'd be like, if I owe somebody some money, that's a liability for me. So owing somebody money is a liability. Owing money is a liability. And now if the owners own it, you always hear of equity in a house. You know, I'm mostly equity. I don't owe much of a mortgage. You know, mortgage would be a liability, and equity in a house, owner's equity, that's what you have in it. But in a business, that's what the owners own. That's how much the owners own out of the building. So owners, if the owners own it, it's equity, and I just started putting owner's equity because that makes more sense to me now. I know, right? After 100, I started putting owner's equity after 100. Okay? So you have an asset, and who owns the asset? Do the owners, or does a third party? I guess is how you could think about it. So the basic accounting equation and the balance sheet are both. All right, we're gonna get rid of this. Oh, I hate to get rid of that nice house. balance sheet and the basic accounting equation are both the same things, and it's assets equal liabilities plus owner's equity or equity. So there, it's in DCA, they're in front of you, and you can just start circling that as well. Like if you want to start writing down your DCA every day, some assets, some liabilities, some equity. I believe I should have showed you that in the previous video, but maybe that was too much or I forgot at the time. But you can circle this, put an equals and a plus, so you know that's your balance sheet. Well, you know, you can say, oh, balance sheet. Well, I don't wanna abbreviate. Cause you're like, what? BS? That's for that bullshit? No, it's for the balance sheet. Okay? So assets equal liability plus owner's equity. Like assets equal liabilities plus owner's equity. We're about running out of time. Sorry for all that. So your assets is your building. Liabilities. 18,000. Owner's equity. 32,000. Assets equal liabilities plus owner's equity. So the house is worth 50,000. Does that make sense? So assets equal 50,000. And does that make sense? You have a $50,000 house. You have liabilities. You owe the bank 18,000 on it, and the owners of the company own 32,000 of it. So anyways, I hope that helped. That was pretty long actually. And anyways, until next time, I'll see you later. And this is CPA Strength, deuces.